And I want to raise a very important issue in County Laois regarding the future of the accident and emergency unit at Portlaoise General Hospital. And as the Minister will be aware, the National Director of Acute Hospital Services published a report where he said the 24/7 A&E unit in Portlaoise was not clinically sustainable, and his report went on to say that the department should be replaced by a medical assessment unit and local injury clinic operating during day hours only. And he went on to say that other services such as daycare, surgery, endoscopy and local injury unit could be developed to make up for the loss of the emergency and surgical facilities, as happened after small other hospitals had closed their units. The Minister for Health then went on to say, in response to the public pressure, that he actually said that there were no plans to close the unit. I accept there's no plans to close the unit, but it's in the offing, the issue of downgrading the unit. There, the Minister's word, absolutely no plans to close the A&E unit. Nobody said about closing. The report said about scaling it down and replacing it. And the Department of Health's own submission to the Department of Public Expenditure as part of the government's comprehensive spending review suggested closing the 24-hour service at 5 hospital emergency departments, including Portlaoise, if the budget were cut. So it's the Department of Health has caused this scare. Maybe they're trying to frighten off Minister Howland's department by saying, if you cut our budget, we'll close A&E. But the fact that the department are actually putting this up as a possibility is undermining the unit in Portlaoise Hospital. And I would just like to say, and the Minister will know, there are 43,000 visits to the A&E unit in Portlaoise every single year. It is actually one of the busiest in all of Ireland. I have the figures from the HSE report published this month for activities to the end of July, and practically one of the busiest A&E units outside of the major capital city.
Thanks, Mike. Thank you very much. On behalf of the Minister for Health, who is unfortunately unable to be here today, I think deputies will understand that, I would like to thank the deputies for raising the issue. As Minister Varadkar has already stated, there are no plans to close the emergency department at the Midland Regional Hospital, Portlaoise. Following on from the CMO's report last January on maternity services in the Midlands Regional Hospital, Portlaoise, and a visit to the hospital by the HSE National Surgical Clinical Programme, the HSE undertook a performance diagnostic to ascertain current performance status of Portlaoise Hospital in relation to all aspects of service provision. The report identified a number of issues and made key recommendations in relation to control, leadership and clinical services at the hospital. The report also pointed to the need for reconfiguration of some services in Portlaoise to ensure that patients are treated in the most appropriate setting by specialist staff that can meet their needs. The overriding concern is to address any patient safety and quality concerns arising. The HSE is working through an action plan with staff in the hospital to stabilise and improve services in Portlaoise Hospital. This includes changes required to enhance existing resources and structures at the hospital to address clinical service deficiencies. A joint governance group has been established to ensure appropriate accountability and oversight of required actions and to incorporate the hospital into the existing governance structures within the Dublin Midlands Hospital Group, which includes St James's and the Coombe, working in collaboration with the Children's Hospital Group. A project team has also been formed to support the work of the governance group, and this team is in the hospital on a regular basis to support staff on the ground. Immediate actions to stabilise service provision include the appointment of an advanced nurse practitioner. A temporary consultant emergency physician has been recruited to address the immediate issues in relation to senior decision making within the emergency department. An additional physician post and replacement post endocrinology and care of the elderly are also being advanced. The joint governance group will also examine the future service configuration at Midlands Regional Hospital, Portlaoise, including emergency department services, and explore opportunities to develop services such as endoscopy and day surgery. Any potential reconfiguration of services in the future will be undertaken in a planned and orderly manner and will take account of existing patient flows, demands in other hospitals and the need to develop particular services at Port Laoise in the context of overall service reconfiguration in the Dublin Midlands Group. On the wider issue raised in relation to the retention of funding for the 24-hour emergency departments and current numbers of beds across the system, recent media reports were based on information related to the department's submission to the Department of Public Expenditure and Reform under the government's comprehensive review of expenditure exercise. This review exercise is carried out every three to four years. The last such review was completed in 2011. As the department's CRE submission is currently under consideration, it would not be appropriate to comment further at this point, except to state that it is currently not planned to implement measures contained in that submission.
Thank you, Minister.
Thank you, Minister. And we just have a very short moment to say, so really, the Department of Health has actually sent a submission to the Department of Public Expenditure and Reform, which suggested the five A&E departments, including Port Laoise, should be downgraded. Now you're saying it's not intended to implement that submission. So the only logical thing is for the department to publicly withdraw that submission, which is the cause of the problem here in Port Laoise. The problem caused in your department with that submission, and it's interesting in your response here, there's no reference at all to the team that was appointed of medical specialists, the National Director of the Acute Hospitals, the then Mr. Ian Carter published this review or commissioned that review that we mentioned, and you haven't dealt with that. So you're saying all the good things on the one hand that is happening, but on the other hand, you're ignoring the report that's there and questioning the sustainability of the unit, and you're not saying that the department should withdraw the submission to power if you have no intention to proceeding with it in any event. And the problem has been a systematic cut in the budget in the last 3 years, and it is undermining public confidence and the confidence of staff in their hospital in Port Laoise.
Very briefly, Cathaoirleach, I don't think anything I would say would satisfy either deputy. I mean, I'm not certain who can, in any circumstances, even in circumstances where we would have more than enough money to do everything we want to do. I don't believe that anyone can say absolutely into the future this won't change. I don't know anyone that can do that. And if you find someone that does, then I suggest you don't believe them. Can I just say that it is intended, and it is understood that Port Laoise is a very busy hospital, and part of the review did take into account patient flow. Could I equally say that the appointment of an advanced nurse practitioner, a temporary consultant emergency physician, that's with A&E departments, has been recruited to address the immediate issues in relation to senior decision making within the emergency department, an additional physician post and replacement post endocrinology and care of the elderly are being advanced. Are they the actions of someone who intends to close a hospital? I would say not. This is the actions of an organisation that is there to ensure that where procedures can safely and quality can be maintained, this is about shoring up a hospital that needs that type of support. So, you know, no matter what I'll say, it won't give you any reassurance. That's your job. That's the job of opposition. But I am telling you that this is the position as it stands, and and on behalf of the Minister for Health, I can assure you that whatever decisions will be made, and there have been considerable decisions made around Port Laoise Hospital, whatever additional decisions will be made around Port Laoise Hospital, it is the intention to ensure that patient safety is paramount at all times.